We'll make a video of crystal oscillator. Now, what is crystal oscillator? It is a device which generates oscillation, but this is all the circuit for crystal oscillator. So you can see you have a transistor SL100 and you have a crystal. Now, what is the criteria about it? It should generate an oscillation without giving any input. And we are providing a DC voltage, no AC with that. Okay, and one, this is an amplifier, one is the, you can see this is a feedback section of, this is a feedback section of a crystal oscillator. Now, what this amplifier is doing is, it is giving a 180 degree phase shift, and a feedback network, this is giving a 180 degree phase shift. This feedback network is also giving a 180 degree phase shift. So total will be 360 degree phase shift in this. It will, this particular crystal oscillator, it will generate a frequency which is exactly equal to the crystal oscillator. And in CRO, we can see the like this kind of sine wave. So here we can calculate the frequency which should be exactly equal to the crystal what we have given. Now you can see the circuit. Now this is like, you can see the transistor, SL100 transistor. With the notch we can make out that this is your emitter, this is your base, and the other one is capacitor. Now the connections are with the with your collector. You can connect a resistor of 1K. This is your resistor of 1K, and you have to give a fixed power supply of 12 volt with the with that 1K, and then you should connect R1 of 15K, and with that series you can connect a 2.7K resistor. Then this particular part has to need to be a, we'll make a common ground, it has to be grounded, and then after that we should hear your if you can see the emitter side, we can see the emitter side, this black wire, the black wire, one side it has been grounded one. Afterwards, what it is having is, it has a capacitor. This is a capacitor, and one more here. You can see a capacitor, and one more you have a resistor of 270 ohms, and then we have connected a pot, which is of 1K. So the pot is varying the voltage. You can vary the waveform with this pot. Now with this, we have to connect a, like from the base. From the base we have to connect a crystal oscillator, and the crystal oscillator, you can see the the output has to be seen here, and we can see the, if we see the output, it should come like a sine wave. So here we can calculate the oscillations and the frequency.